So today I'm spending every single coin I have on Hypixel Skyblock on a very expensive weapon. And basically I just want to see if it's worth it. But before we do get into the video, if you do watch my videos and you haven't subscribed, please make sure you do so. We're on the road to 2k. Let's just get there as quick as we can. Anyway, let's get into the video. I hope you enjoy it. So at the moment, I don't actually have enough coins for what I want to buy. And what I want to buy is pretty much a maxed out giant sword. So if we actually have a look, I have 129 million at the moment. And the one that I want is 136 mil. So I'm going to be taking a loan off my sister of about 6.5 million coins just so I can buy this. So yeah, you can stop dancing. So we're going to... What is that music? Can you hear that music?
It's my pants.
Can you take them off, please? Right, anyway, yeah. I'm ready for the loan, so if you can trade me, send over the funds, you are the bank. Hello? Am I talking to a brick wall? Right, well, this just isn't going to plan. I'm supposed to be getting a loan off this person. Oh, dear. Alright, there we go. You're still being weird, but I guess I'll take... I'll take the coins. Come on. Let's have a seat. Anytime today, you know, not waiting on anything. There we go, she's done it some weird way, but I've taken the gift and hopefully
the gift? The auction. What do you mean the gift?
Well, the loan. So we're on the auction house and the one that I actually wanted has gone up a million price, so now I can't afford the fuming potatoes one, which is 136.9 and I only have 136.2. So I think what we're going to do is just settle for the hot potatoes one. Which we can pick up for 135 mil, which is still a fairly good deal. It's a pretty standard price. So we're going to go ahead and buy it. So 135 mil on this sword, pretty much everything I could scrape together, plus a loan just to get this. So it better be good. What we're going to do is we're going to go and test it in the graveyard and also test it in dungeons. And hopefully we can see a big improvement from the Livid Dagger. So I'm that poor that I had to sell my damaging pet, which is my griffin, because I use a blue whale for, no, not a blue whale, I use a yeti for dungeons. So I've actually also had to borrow a pet off my sister because I had to sell my griffin. So yeah, that's something. And for anyone that's wondering, this is the armor set that I do have on. I am aware that outside of dungeons, it's obviously not favorable to have any sort of like golden head, but we're just going to go with it because this is a set that I do use for dungeons. So anyway, let's see what damage we do to this zombie. 229k. I mean, my Livid Dagger did that in the back. It didn't do it in a front hit. Considering the Livid Dagger is like 120 mil less expensive. It's a bit underwhelming. Although that could just be down to my pet. And the fact that I don't have full Necron on. I only have the golden head. I'm not sure how I feel about it, to be honest. Now, for anyone that is wondering, obviously there's a lot of things that contribute to dealing damage. If I go over to my accessory bag, these are the accessories that I have on this page as well. And they're all reforged to shaded, so that is pretty much not the optimal reforged for damaging, because obviously it goes into the then rarities and what you should actually have for each rarity, but it's pretty much the general best optimization for actual damage. So obviously, I don't have all the talismans, and only one of them is Recombob because I got it as like pretty much a gift. But yeah, anyway, we need to just move on. Now, what I'm going to do is I have this Livid Dagger, which I was, you know, just given as a tester from my sister again, which is pretty much the equivalent of it. It's not Recombob. This is pretty much what I had. Mine was Fabled, but anyway, 103k in the front. That's very similar to what I was doing, and 206k in the back. So if you can get a back hit with the Livid Dagger, it's pretty much the same as the equivalent giant sword. Obviously, the front hit is double. But yeah, that gives you a bit more of an idea in terms of comparison. To be honest, it could just be to do with the pet, although that is a similar amount of damage that I was doing prior. So what we're going to do now is we're going to go into a floor 6, and we're pretty much just going to compare the damage from the giant sword to the Livid Dagger and see if it's actually worth it. So to be honest with you, I've been quite underwhelmed. The price tag, I'm really not sure about it. So what I actually completely forgot about is the ability that it has. That was pretty OP. I guess it's just a massive Livid Dagger in effect. It did 284k damage. Obviously that would probably scale in dungeons, so it's really not too bad. But I'm a little bit underwhelmed by this, to be honest. And there is a massive cooldown on the ability, so Obviously, using one for all, you can't even ultimate-wise. Yeah. You know, I'm not sure about it. Anyway, let's test it out in dungeons. So, if we just test out this Livid Dagger at the moment, we're doing roughly, by the looks of it, around 5 million damage per hit. Which is not bad, but I would have sort of expected more. I think the problem is with the Giant Sword is, obviously, if you look at the stats, it doesn't actually have like a base crit damage buff, which is sort of annoying. So we're gonna try the ability, and as you can see, I mean, it doesn't actually kill everything, but it's quite a good ability. It's not bad for clearing. The only downside is the massive cooldown. It did do 9 million damage, as you saw though, which is quite ridiculous. But we are suffering from not having lifesteal, to be honest. That is a big factor. And just the fact that I've got one for all on it is sort of almost making me suffer. Now we'll see how we go on against this Lost Adventurer. Always used to spamming right click with a Living Dagger. And it's really not killing that much faster, to be honest. Yeah, it's not really. I can't justify the price difference. I don't understand why it's so different in price. Like 135 mil as opposed to 17 mil. I really can't see the price difference in these two weapons. So as you can see, maybe I don't have the right reforges or something like that. Maybe Wizard's better than Fabled, or I don't know. If you guys do know or have any advice and think I'm doing anything wrong, then please let me know, because I just assumed that it would increase my damage massively, and it really hasn't. It has increased my damage a little bit, granted. Probably by about maybe 750k to a million damage per hit. But for the price, you'd be expecting a lot more, and I was expecting a lot more. Now, I understand that a lot of people wouldn't recommend the Giant Sword whatsoever as a Berserk, which I understand, but then other people at the same time say it's a game-breaking, like a game-changer. So I don't really know who to believe. So I thought I'd test it out for myself. And to be honest with you, I'm probably not going to stick with it. I don't know. I think I'll be better off having the coins and spending them on something like talismans or recon bombing talismans, or just saving up for a Valkyrie instead or something like that, because I assume that must be way better. So in case you're wondering what my overall sort of verdict is on the Giant Sword, if you come over to my listings, I've already sold it, so that's what I thought of it. So basically what my plan is to do is basically just buy a very similar Livid Dagger back to what I actually had originally, because for the money, I'd probably argue it's better when you take into consideration the money, definitely. Obviously, the damage isn't quite as good in dungeons, but it's really not much difference. And as for outside of dungeons, I actually do more damage with a back hit, with the Livid Dagger rather than the Giant Sword. Obviously, in the front, I don't do as much damage, but I cannot justify the coins, especially when I don't really have that money in comparison to the actual sword. So I guess all I really have to say is, if you're a Berserk and you're wondering if a Giant Sword's actually good, it is, but it's not worth it. So I'd probably just stick with a Livid Dagger until you can afford a Valkyrie. Unless you have a stupid amount of coins, then in that case, buy it. But if you have a stupid amount of coins, then buy a Valkyrie or a Scylla. Don't waste your money on a Giant Sword as a Berserk. But yeah, that is pretty much the end of the video. You've seen me waste a lot of coins, and you've seen me pretty much be disappointed with a weapon that should be good. But anyway, if you did enjoy the video, make sure you do leave a like. As always, subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you.